I went from 0 to over 50,000 listeners on Spotify, and this is how I did it. Hey, it's John here at Hyped It. As an artist on Spotify, I recently crossed the threshold of 50,000 monthly listeners. And so I decided to take inventory, look into my listener numbers on Spotify for Artists to answer the question, how did I go from 0 to over 50,000 monthly listeners? What's working? What isn't working? And what should I double down on to keep growing? So to look at the numbers, I'm gonna hop over to my screen. Let's jump right in. I'm logged into Spotify for Artists. You can see my stats here for the last 28 days. And one of the questions I've been asking myself is, where are those listeners coming from? And the reason this is an interesting question to me is simply that I'm excited about having crossed this threshold over 50,000 listeners. So some of the things I'm doing, they work. And I wanna make sure I can double down on the things that work. And this is why it's critical for me to understand where exactly are my streams coming from. Now, luckily, I can dive deeper into this here inside Spotify for Artists by looking at the source of streams. And if I open this up here, I get a couple of options. And the ones that I really want to look at are the ones that give me a material contribution to my monthly listeners. So what I did here is I just clicked through this. And you know, some of them are higher, some of them are lower. For example, editorial playlist, I know this basically stays at 0. So the ones that I wanted to focus on here primarily are listeners' own playlist and library, because this is a significant contributor. Algorithmic playlists and mixes, other listeners' playlists, and radio and autoplay. Those are the ones where I get the majority of listeners. If I, you know, try some of these other ones here, you can see they just hover around the 0 line. There's virtually no contribution from these other ones here. Maybe just a little bit, but not enough to count. And if I finish my selection here, all I can do is click on done. And now I can see the timeline here. But what's more interesting, I can literally see the number of listeners over that 28-day time period that were coming from all of those different sources of listeners. So now what I did is I took those listener numbers here for the last 28 days and I brought them over into a spreadsheet. And the reason why I did this is I wanted to be able to figure out what's the percentage to total number of listeners that each of these contributes. So, you know, remember these numbers here, and you'll see the same numbers exactly here on the spreadsheet again. All I did is I ordered them from high to low. Now, one of the things I noticed, and full disclosure here, is that if I added up all those numbers in my spreadsheet, the total number of listeners came out about 300 to 400 higher than the number of listeners that I'm being shown here inside Spotify. I don't have a perfect explanation for this. I don't think Spotify is double counting listeners anywhere. So maybe it's because of slightly different date ranges. Maybe this varies by a day, more or less the way it's displayed here, or with the way Spotify computes this number here. I don't exactly know, but I wanted to point out that there's a very small difference between the numbers that I added up here. But anyway, that difference aside, what I'm seeing here is that radio and autoplay is giving me 42% contribution to my total number of listeners. And for this category, I have 31% listeners contributed here. Next up is algorithmic playlists and mixes. That's predominantly Release Radar and Discover Weekly. There are some, you know, smaller algorithmic playlists as well. This adds up to 13% of all listeners. And then I have this category here, other listeners playlists. And that contributes 14%. And what this represents is listeners that listen to your music on a playlist owned by someone else. And a good example, again, is my This Is John Gold playlist. So if music fans listen to my music here, I own this playlist. And so this would fall into this category. Now, this is a good starting point. So now I have some numbers here. But what I'm really curious about is how those numbers relate to my music promotion activities. So what I'm looking at is literally, which of these streams do I actually have to work hard for, and which ones do I get for free? Now, radio and autoplay is something that Spotify gives to me for free. Listeners own playlist and library. As fans who discover my music, they saved it, they came back to it. And this is also free. And then we have algorithmic playlists and mixes, which is Spotify sharing my music with other listeners. is also free. Now, last but not least, we have other listeners' playlists. And in this particular case, I know that this is not for free because this is where I'm running my ad campaigns to bring fans over to my This Is John Gold playlist and discover my music here. There might, of course, be other playlists out there on Spotify. In fact, I know there are lots of them, right? My music has been added to over 6,000 playlists. So there are lots of other playlists where music fans can discover my music and it would fall into this category. But I know that this entire category can't be for free because my own playlist that I feed with promotion is also in here. So I'm gonna say that I run ads for these. But if I add this up, right, if I take the top three here, that is over 85%. Over 85% of my listeners are for free. And I love this because what it means is that the promotion that I do and that I do invest into, which for me is ad campaigns, has such a big multiplying effect that it really ends up being only a fraction of the listeners that I send into Spotify. And from there, because it helps Spotify recognize the types of music fans that love my music and it raises the popularity score of my songs, it multiplies into 85% of listeners coming to my music entirely for free. And so to me, this seems like a great system. And the reason that it works specifically with ads is that with music ads, I'm getting my music in front of an audience that already loves my genre and my style of music. With music ads, I can laser target that audience. And then all I do is I'll bring them over to me on Spotify because the only thing standing between these music fans that already love the kind of music that I make and listening to my music is that they have not discovered me yet. They don't know that I exist yet. And with ads, it's so easy to close that gap. So they come over to Spotify, they're very likely to fall in love with my music, and then they save it. They add it to their own playlists. They start following me. All of these are great positive signals to the Spotify algorithm to then go and say, oh, something's really happening with John's music here. So we're gonna put it on more release radio. We're gonna put it on more Discover Weekly. We're gonna put it on more radio, all of which is free exposure for my music. Now you might be wondering, John, how do you use Discovery Mode in all of this? Discovery Mode is this feature in Spotify where you can have Spotify give some of your songs more exposure through radio and autoplay by giving up a portion of the royalties that would otherwise be generated by those streams. And the thing here is that the music distributor that I've been using for my own label for a long time didn't opt into Spotify's Discovery Mode program. So my music distributed through them did not have any opportunity to get on Discovery Mode. And so what I've been testing recently is I've pushed out a few songs through DistroKid. And for those, I had the opportunity to opting into Discovery Mode. And so right now I have 7 songs that are supported by Discovery Mode. But I will say that even before using Discovery Mode, radio and autoplay has historically been the biggest contributors of streams on my music. So I'm super excited about what's happening with the music here and the fact that the way I run these ad campaigns triggers such a multiplier effect in Spotify, where it just turns into tens of thousands of free listeners and streams. And so I'll keep doing what I'm doing and even figure out ways to do more of it. Now, if you're wondering, John, so what is it that you do for your ad campaigns? Then let me share this. I'm using Hypedit to automatically create and run my ad campaigns for my music. I do this because it saves me tons of time, literally takes less than 10 minutes to launch a campaign. And I know these campaigns work. So I have full trust in the results that I'm getting. And if you want to discover how to run one of these campaigns for your own music, let me leave a link above to a video here on YouTube where I share click by click how I launch one of those campaigns in just minutes. And the amazing thing is this works for new music. This works for old music out on Spotify. Really, as long as your music's on Spotify, this just works. So if what I've shown you here inspires you and you'd love to get a multiplier effect for your music similar to this one going, where you bring such high quality listeners over to Spotify that Spotify is just more likely to get you more radio exposure, more algorithmic exposure, you get more listeners and streams from fans saving you music, then just give this a try. It really couldn't be easier and more fun to launch and run these simple music ad campaigns and see more listeners, streams, and fans on Spotify. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like, the subscribe, and the bell icon below so you can get more videos like this on YouTube about how to get more listeners, streams, and fans for your music on Spotify. And if you want to discover click by click how I run and stack these ad campaigns that have gotten me from zero to now over 50,000 listeners on Spotify, then check out this next clip right here. Want to get your music heard on Spotify with AI? I just launched a brand new video training program called the Spotify Growth Switch, where I show you how to start growing real listeners, real fans, and real streams on Spotify in less than 10 minutes using software and AI. I've used the Spotify Growth Switch system to now grow my music to over 7 million streams and tens of thousands of monthly listeners on Spotify. This works for any music genre. It gets you real fans and listeners super fast, and it's extremely easy to set up, literally just like flipping a spotlight switch for your music. Despite using AI, you don't need to know nothing about tech stuff in order to be successful with this. I've had the tremendous privilege of helping multiple tens of thousands of music artists grow their music on Spotify, many of which have grown to much larger numbers, lots more listeners, lots more streams than I have using the systems that I've taught. Makes me so proud of their success. And so if you want to get more real listeners, real fans, and real streams for your music fast using state-of-the-art software and AI, then click the link below this video and check out the Spotify Growth Switch. I can't wait to help you grow your music on Spotify, and I look forward to seeing you on the inside.